Kedmil, you loathsome witch hunters. Welcome back to The Witcher 3. I am Dimsey, and I am also pissed. This is the second attempt, I try to record this episode, because I tried to do this episode once already, and straight up, I just rage quitted. I just fucking rage quitted. Fuck. I'll let you know why in a second. First, let's talk to Ibeer. Bro!
Greetings.
Greetings.
We're here for a very specific reason. We're not here to... Actually, now that we are here...
What do you have on offer?
Let me show you a thing. Let me show you something. Really cool. Remember how Ibeer was a dumpling cook before? Well, if you scroll down as far down as you can in his little, you know, vendor shop window... you can buy dumplings from him, which we shall do, naturally, of course, no doubt about it. And it's pretty cool that they added that little detail, that you can still buy dumplings from him even though he's no longer a dumpling chef, or a chef who specializes in dumplings, I suppose. But today we're gonna do this, Count Romley's figurine. We are going to dismantle this and we are gonna get... Count Romley's will and the ornate key. Let's do it. Oh yeah. This is the first time I've done this. Well, technically not, because I did record this once before, but I just rage quitted.
So long.
Yeah, that happened. Let's read the will. It is a quest item. Count Romley's will. To Robert, my son, if you receive... Let me do that again. What the hell is wrong with my voice? Is it dry? I have no idea. Maybe I'm parched. Fuck, I should have brought some water. Anyways, if you've received the figurine, it means your father has departed his veil of tears. I know we've had no contact for many years, but I hope the contents of the chest opened by the key included within will, in some small way, compensate for all the lost time. You'll find the chest in the underground quarters of our family home, Arnskrone Castle. Your loving father, Count Walter May Romley. A dark legacy. Oh, it doesn't have a suggested level. Cool, cool. And this is where we need to go, which is fucking awesome, because I only have three points of interest, or undiscovered locations, I guess, left. Here, in Novigrad, and Velen. And, I figured I'm gonna do all three today. Plus, a dark legacy, so this is perfect. Woo! Let's do it, or let's attempt to do it. Oh my god. I'm not gonna rage quit this episode, I promise. Basically what happened in the previous, attempt, was that, I wasn't mentally prepared for the difficulty, for the amount of shit that I was walking into when I started fighting the monsters surrounding some of those points of interest. Oh, and by the way, apparently this is an event. You can actually, like, it's not a quest or anything, you can just, like, interact with this, you can actually save those two there who are... lying on the ground. I don't know if that still applies, however. May have missed the chance for doing that. You're supposed to do that by the... sometime before the mages leave Novigrad, I think? Speaking of mages leaving Novigrad, this is a friend of Triss. We actually met him at the Vigilbud estate when the ball was in full swing. And he was one of those who refused to accept Triss's help. So he burned at the pyre. He was burned alive. By witch hunters and I guess these... I don't know, Redinian guardsmen? Novigrad guardsmen? Whatever, the guardsmen. And But you can actually interrupt that as well. That's what I was trying to say before I... just started babbling, which I always do. Horrible fucking habit, but what can you do? So you can save him. Same thing as before with the couple. that's being harassed inside the Novigrad walls. All you need to do is just interrupt and basically just, you know, whip out your sword and go to town. Can't believe I haven't noticed that. All those hours I've poured into this game and still discovering shit that I didn't know about. It's cray cray, yo. Oh, fuck me. Let me just take a second and appreciate the view. We see some shooting stars as well. Oh my god. Whew. Said it many times before. I'm not gonna say it now, alright? You know what I'm gonna say. Do you know what I'm gonna say? I was gonna say, this game is just beyond beautiful. As if that wasn't obvious just by looking at it. I mean, look at this, look at this. CD Projekt Red, man, they did it. They did it. If they wanted to portray a wandering, poor monster slayer on the road, killing monsters and collecting measly pay from it, I think they did a pretty good job. Of course, I am minted right now. I am rich beyond imagination. I can probably, like, buy Novigrad with this coin. Like, it's crazy. Oh, shit. Now it begins. Oh, my God. Alright, so this is where I rage quit it. Yeah, I know. I didn't play very far. Yeah, I guess we'll save there. So the problem is, it's not so much that the enemies are, you know, super tough or anything. What am I doing? Oils. Insectoid. There we go. It's more that they have an obscene amount of health, and it's just aggravating to stand there for 8 years trying to kill them. We see some Arcas here in the vicinity. I'm hoping to aggro only one of them, because there are three of them. But if, alright, if they don't want to fight, then I'll just continue on. I'll switch out my oil then for Necrophage. And now I'm heading into a fight that's no more, no easier than the Arrakis down below. And here we are at the very first point of interest in this video. And it looks like we're in a cemetery. Cool.
Well, come on.
Oh, goody. So we're fighting ghouls. Makes sense to fight them in a cemetery. Makes sense. Very Witcher 1. 1-esque. This is something that you... Oh, no. They're actually... Oh, wow. Okay, so this is unfortunate. They just ran up to the second level of the cemetery. Which is unfortunate because a bunch of their friends are actually there. So, yeah, I don't know what to do now. Fuck, this is aggravating. Okay, well, I guess we have no choice. We'll just have to follow them. Oh, goody, 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 goody. Let me just get into a rhythm first before I start attacking. Because I do not want to be, Oh, right, the new guy is an Al'Ghul. Shit, I forgot. In other words, try to avoid hitting him even once. Let's see if I can, somehow encourage them to come down here, and maybe I can fight them one-on-one or something. I don't know, probably not. All right, or maybe I can just do this, go up and down these stairs. Ooh, this is dangerous. This is dangerous. Fighting, attacking when there's so many grouped up like that. Fuck this guy. Wait, Axie. Ah, but using it now is kind of dangerous, because using Axie puts me at an insane risk. So let me just see if I can at least kill one of these guys. Doesn't look like I'll be able to, though. Oh, goddamn. Alright, I got hit. That's okay, though. I'm gonna have to get hit. There's so many of them, I mean. Not getting hit by, like, 7 ghouls that you're fighting at the same time. Oh, god. So I'm almost dead. Let me pop a fucking swallow. Let's not take any chances. Don't rage quit. Don't get mad. Chill. Just be cool. Be cool. The problem with this fight is that there are, like, I don't know, 7, I think? There are 7 ghouls, and they all have an obscene amount of health. Way too much. Way too much. Usually you want to balance out a combat encounter by, I guess, you know, balancing out and distributing the amount of threat that each enemy poses exponentially. So if you're fighting 2 guys, you know, you can give them a bit more health. Yeah. That's cool. That's fine. You know, there's only 2 of them, yeah, so it's easier to manage. But if you're fighting 7 of them, and they all have as much health as the instance where you fight 2 enemies, that's where things become just a bit weird. Let's see if I can maybe kill one at the very beginning here. Come on. If I can kill one of them... Ah, shit. Oh no, I've lost track of who it was. Well, isn't... Oh, there he is. Okay, I got him. Excellent. Well, so far so good. I got one of them. Shit's going a lot smoother than before, at least. Oof. Okay. Holy fuck. Okay, another one spawned. Excellent. Why not, I guess.
Die.
No, I need to prevent it from... Shit. Okay, well... Right, well, what do I do now? Maybe I can aggro one of them. No. Doesn't look like that worked, but there is one straggler here, I never knew that. Alright. I don't know, let me not lock on. There's way too many of them.
How long are you gonna make me wait?
And I wanna be ready in case another one pops up. Okay, holy shit, he turned fast there, wow. Alright, another ghoul is coming up from the second level of the cemetery. Ah, but it doesn't matter, because this guy's dead. Excellent. Alright, let's go. So far, so good. 2 dead. I've taken a couple of hits, but fuck. Got me some slack. Here's the Owl Ghoul. I guess he's the chief. There we go. Oh, fuck me. If I can just fight this guy now, I would be, I guess that was wishful thinking. I shouldn't even have... Okay. Okay, now I was kind of in a pretty nice position to pull off Axie, so... Oh, god damn. God damn. Alright, let me see. Let me see what I can do. Getting swarmed by these 4 guys. Okay. No, but what the fuck was that? I guess the first one broke my block and stunlocked me, allowing for that guy to just one-shot me. You see why? Okay. Oh my god. Fuck me. Alright, don't rage quit. You defeated the Toad Prince for the love of shit. You beat the Toad Prince. You can beat these guys. These are just ghouls. You fought them many times before. You're prepared. You know how many there are. You have a pretty good tactic for fighting them. You aren't, you know, you're not a god playing games, but you're pretty decent. So what's the fucking problem? Just concentrate. Do it, motherfucker. Just do it. I guess I'll just have to keep in mind I am still following my little rule where I'm not allowed to use Quen. So in case you think I'm a baddie, I am. I'm not disputing that, but I'm just saying that
not bad.
I am using a restriction to how I play because, you know, the added challenge. So I am absolutely, you know, lying in the bed I've made. Alright, well, killing just one of these guys was insane, but it is doable. It was wishful thinking, pulling off two Rens in a row. Actually, hold up. Oh, but if I use Axie, I won't be able to rogue it, to rend. Alright. Oh, thank God, I canceled the attack there. Oddly enough, my counterattack doesn't seem to do anything. Well, maybe it does, because this guy's dead. Whoop. Another one's gonna spawn. Yep. Both of us dodged. Excellent. Let's go. I'm fully committed to killing these guys. And hopefully not taking a single hit in the process, so I can redeem my two earlier shitty attempts at fighting these assholes. Come on. Comes a bit. Fine. I'll fight this guy down here. Oh, there. Whoa, two of the spawn? What the fuck? This is insane. How many are there? I mean, I know this is a cemetery. It makes perfect sense for there to be this many ghouls here, but... And we can see the Arakas walking outside. Oh my god. No, please no. No, 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 wait, stop. What the fuck? I pulled... Okay, so they just ignored my Axie and just... Oh, goody. Okay, good. Good, good. This is excellent. This is excelente. Ooh, the other one is coming. I need to be careful. Another one bites the dust. Let's go. Let's keep it on. Let's keep it up. I can do this, goddammit. Okay, I say that.
Die.
Alright, let's... Oh, no, no, no. Let's not stand here. Let's stand by the stairs. Make sure that he can run up. Oh my god, this is what I'm talking about. So far, so very good, but, you know, to quote the great philosopher Hansus Solisius, don't get cocky, kid. Alright, let's see. Let's pick up all this shit because I'm a loot whore. You know what? Fuck it. I'm gonna save. yeah, this is the one. Oh my god, can I somehow aggro these guys down here? Or are they gonna just leash? Stop leashing. Get up. Get down. Get down. Come on. Get up. Get up. Oh no. Get up. No, no. Come on. No, they're not falling for it. Damn it. Well, alright. You know what? Fighting three of these guys is much better than fighting all of them. All of the ghouls. And the universe. At the same time. Ooged. Oh my god. Okay. It's okay. It's okay that I, you know, missed my target. It's cool. Nope. Wrong guy. Excellent. Once again, I hit the wrong guy, but that's okay. Because I got him now. Oh, and the other fucking ghoul ran away. What? This ogle is fucking mine. Holy shit, are you serious right now? Dodge all you want. Dodge all you want. Oh my god, I can't believe I... Well, now we know how to defeat all these assholes. Separate them. I guess that was pretty obvious from the get-go, but... It's a lot... Okay. It's a lot easier to say, you know, to exclaim, alright, this is the tactic that you have to do. But putting that plan into motion, something completely different, yo. It's not the same thing at all. Alright, now I've got a pretty good flow. Maybe I shouldn't have said that. Maybe I'm just gonna jinx myself now. Ah, all these branches and trees and fucking bushes. That's okay. That's cool. If only I could just, like, get one rend off. I should be able to just end it. Oh, you're gonna run away? Come on. Alright, so they really are just tied to this place for some reason. Okay, oh my god, are you serious? I've done it. This is the battle of the ages, the battle of the cemetery, yo. So I just missed the counterattack. I hate the fact that Geralt parries, but then when he does his counterattack, he takes a step back, which often just misses the target. As somebody who loves to parry in games, that's fucking beyond aggravating. But I did it! Woo! I fucking did it, yo! I fucking did it! Holy shit. Save. Save. I'm not doing that again. This is the fight. Well, actually, no. The reason I rage quitted it before is because I fought the Arrakis before fighting these guys. I don't know. That I'm genuinely not even gonna try to do because I can't I can't even begin to describe just how insane it is to fight three of those insane fucks, who can poison you, who can spit web at you and like pull you in various different directions, and I can't. That's just aggravating and not fun, and I'm not doing that. No way. Fuck that. Forget it. Maybe I'll come back someday and kick their asses, but right now I'm not in the mood. I'm gonna go out on a limb here and assume that there's gonna be a wraith popping up. I don't remember this place, so oh my. Damn, there's some good stuff here. Ooh, silver plate. Yo, for real, there's some good stuff here. Was it worth fighting all those guys? Actually, I think it was, yeah. Some really fucking sweet stuff that we just picked up. And I mean, unfortunately, we did also, you know, lose a bunch of time here, but... I know, that's the nature of these things. Sometimes you just hit upon a wall, man, and you just have to keep on banging your head against the wall and just hope that eventually you'll at least crack it a little bit. And then all hell breaks loose. Because then you know that you can in fact destroy the wall. It'll take time, sure. You can't read any of these tombstones. That's a shame, because you can do that in Beauclair. And my god, there's some funny fucking epitaphs written on some of those gravestones. It's great. Alright, so I don't know if there's a road necessarily leading to my next destination, so I'll just walk right here, walk right through the wildlands, through this little bog. Not that I mind. The view is quite spectacular. Woof! Oh, damn you. Damn bushes. I don't know if I've mentioned it, but this should be the last episode. Or not the last episode. I should just say that in the next episode, we will be traveling to Toussaint. That's right. Blood and Wine videos start with the next video. In the next episode, we are gonna be traveling to... Damn, I've forgotten the name of the village. The quarry village, you know, where we find Peyrak Peyran and his friend. Ooh, I'm going in a very odd direction. Let me just check what the name of that place is, by the way. Wait, where is it? Where is it? Oh, Stonecutter Settlement. Oh, I went way too far south. Stonecutter Settlement. No way, I was gonna remember that. Alright, so I guess we're taking a bit of a weird route today. Why not? Exploring the woods. I guess this is part of the Dead White Wood. But these... Oh shit, way too much vegetation. Yeah. There we have confirmation. Oh, I fucked up. Is there only one of them? If there's only one of them... I guess that's fine, but... Oh my god, I don't... Got it. That's insane. You know what, I need to stop heavy hitting him. Okay. Let me just use my witch senses. Oh god. Let's run away from them. Okay, so that was the first time I've ever been ambushed in The Witcher 3, and holy shit, what an ambush it was. Wow, that genuinely freaked me out. Okay, yeah, so in any case, like I was saying, in the next episode we will be traveling to the Stonecutter Settlement and meeting up with the two knights there who are gonna contract us to kill a nefarious beast. Oh god, are those wolves? I guess those are wolves. Mm-hmm. Oh, fighting wolves. Oh god, this is not gonna be pleasant at all, is it? Let me save. Because I suspect I'm gonna get my ass kicked by these wolves. Oh boy, royally too. No, let's see. Where's the beast? Well, and I guess that could be sure. Right, that, okay, now I remember. There's also a Leshen. Right, my bad. I forgot about the Leshen. More like, repressed. Alright, let's do it. We'll be fighting him at one hell of a cool location, though. That's for certain. Let's eat some food, and, God. Damn, this place, Woof! Looks cool as shit. Alright, let's do it. Now, the wolves are a huge pro- Wow, I'm already dead. You know what? There's way too many wolves. I'm gonna die. I want to remind everybody that this is New Game Plus, Deathmarch, cut me some slack, and remember... No, fuck it, there's no excuses. I mean... You can kind of tell that, goddamn. All I really wanted was some kind of AI code that said, if one attacks, then all others passive. That's it. That's all I wanted. Just one line of code that just informs the enemies to just... What the fuck did I just do? Did I just put down another oil on top of... Hold up. Yeah, okay, that's exactly what I did. But beast there. Fuck it, let's try to kill the wolves first. I usually try to ignore the wolves because, well, one, there's so many of them. Two, I hate fighting them. And three, they respawn. The Leshen summons new ones. Oh, here comes the, whoop! I was prepared for that, I heard it. Wait, what? Oh my god, these guys... Alright, so I guess because they're summoned by the Leshen, they count as monsters. That's interesting. Alright, there we go. Now we do a proper damage. Oh fuck me, this is... Time to end this. Thank god he can hit his own, because I'd be in deep shit if he couldn't. Ah, damn. Alright, the wolves didn't have that much health, actually. Wow, that was an insane dodge. And I'm gonna take this opportunity to sneak in a couple of hits on this guy. Alright, those are just the ravens. They don't do much damage. I don't need to panic.
How long are you gonna make me wait?
Damn, Leshen. He's moving around. I can't sneak a Rendon on him. I guess that's fine. Alright. There he is. No. Okay, he summoned his dogs again, I think, so...
Damn, you're ugly.
Let's see if we can... Finish him off, damn. Okay. Well, at least his dogs haven't showed up yet, so... Is that because we're, like, interrupting him before he manages to, like, finish the call, maybe? Because that would be sweet. Nope. 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 Here they are. Nope. Fuck. Damn the ravens. They're more annoying than anything else. Kind of throw me off my game, you know. Got a good rhythm going on here, and I don't want anything to fuck it up for me. I hate these wolves. I hate the fact that when they attack, they kind of scurry away. Die already. Die already. Or don't. Fuck. Oh my god, he's dead. Any more wolves coming? No, there seems to be some enemies up in the castle. I think there's more wolves. Oh my god, I can't believe I did it. Oh my god. Whew. I don't know, I guess I shouldn't be feeling too proud of myself. No, but come on, that first attempt was just, you know, feeling the boss. It's not a boss, not even a mini boss. But you know what I mean. Leshens aren't to be fucked with, you know. And they sure feel like mini-bosses. Travel post here. Let's read the lore for this castle. If I can, there we go. In its glory days, this castle buzzed with life as the hub of the Romilly family activities. Today, it is merely a dangerous ruin in the heart of a cursed wood. The fact that they specifically mention in the heart of a cursed wood leads me to believe that maybe this is where, where it all kind of began. The origin for the bad reputation that this forest has gotten, and maybe also the way, the reason why it looks so fucking desolate and decrepit and horrible and and evil. Alright, there is one more wolf, but he has not seen me yet. Wait, am I doing damage? Oh, okay, these are... You see? It's really weird. I need to switch blade now. Man, it's weird how that works, man. How sometimes some... Well, I mean... Whoa! That one wolf just did 4,400 health? Right, okay, well I need to be a lot more careful then. I need to really get into some kind of rhythm here and finding an opening. Oh, that was very dangerous. Alright, so dodging towards them kind of puts them in this kind of defensive position, or defensive state, I guess. Oh, goddamn. Thank god you can cancel attacks now. I don't remember you being able to do that in vanilla. Ah! There is the ultra move, sweet. If I can, oh, I lost it. Okay. Well. Yippee. I'm using Iris. The, von Everick family blade, I suppose. Or, I guess, Allgear's blade, really. Well, I mean, I guess I killed him. Oh! I can go fuck myself. Alright, he's dead now. What the fuck? Wow. Okay. Okay. Wow, this is... Yeah. This entire episode has just been a clusterfuck. Whew. I mean, I don't know why. You know? I mean, I've been playing this game for so long. And I've been playing on this playthrough for so long that, you know, you'd think that I wouldn't be, I wouldn't be caught off guard by the insane amount of health and the insane amount of damage that the animals have and do. Let's head inside this castle now. But, I mean, I am, because goddammit. It's a fucking wolf. I don't know, I kinda expect it to be not as vicious and not as tough to beat. But I guess, you know. Joke's on me. No, but I mean the problem isn't really, you know, the fact that the wolves do so much damage. It is the AI, the fact that they can attack simultaneously and basically just gang up on you. Oh, I wanted to light the candle, but I guess I can't. Let's read. I'm fucking Japanesey breezy here up in this bitch. Let's read Count Romilly's journal, part one. Oh, this is a lot of text. Okay, entries in chronological order. Last few pages missing, torn out. This craft has proved even more profitable than I had anticipated. Five of the last seven kidnappings ended in success. Only two of the lads had fathers too miserly to ransom their sons. Or I guess miserly? Clearly was more offspring where those... Oh. Why do you even try to read when I can't read? Fuck. Clearly was more offspring than where those came from. Oh, that's such an odd sentence, I'm sorry. So the calculating knaves deemed the captured snots expendable. Note for the future. Demand a significantly smaller ransom from clients with more than one male heir. I sent the lads after Anastasia von Borma. The Lord of Zutzer Castle is a magnificently wealthy noble and Anastasia is his only child. I smell a lucrative transaction. The lads returned with the client's daughter that very night. The girl is calm, apathetic even. Something strange is afoot in the castle surroundings. Flock of ravens perch in the trees bordering the courtyard. Ah, I know what's up, okay. This morning, a new contingent flew in. Two serving maids have gone missing. Could my lads have been responsible? Or did those ravens peck them to death? Here a giant ink blot covers half the page. One of my grooms have died. From what From what the remaining servants recount, he was killed by tree roots that suddenly thrust straight out of the ground. My men are petrified. Wolves howl day and night in the land surrounding the estate. Basically what's happening here. What all of this means is that the girl that they kidnapped, this Anastasia girl, was marked by the Leshen. And now the Leshen prowls this area instead, because the Leshen has to be near the lady at all times. Leaving the castle walls means certain death. We have we have barricaded ourselves inside and live as if under siege. Luckily, we've ample supplies of food and water. Perhaps this is some kind of curse. Franz, the servant who led the unit that kidnapped Anastasia, has hanged himself. Black magic is surely at work. I must search the castle library for some indication what this might be. Pretty cool, you know, pretty cool that we get to get the backstory for this area. Kind of get a sense for, what exactly is going on here. Why was there a Leshen prowling these woods? And, why the hell? Oh, shit. Not Quen. Not Quen. I'm not using... Okay, damn. Oh, no. Oh my god, are you serious? Three of them? Are you fucking serious? Three of them in this small space. Oh god, did I save? I don't think I saved. They don't seem to do that much damage, though. Okay, they don't do that much damage, thank god. The only saving grace. Ah, that's not to say that I should get careless. Please die. Please die. I can barely even see anything. Like, do you see what I'm talking about? Come on. I'm not trying to be a whiny little bitch, but the fact that they can all just gang up on you like that and just spam their attacks until you're just destroyed. whatever. Fuck it. I guess we'll have to, This is so aggravating. Oh, my kind of made some noise. I'll have to edit that out because I know that sharp noises when the microphone picks it up, it's kind of aggravating. It's kind of annoying. Don't worry, I'll edit that out. Okay, I didn't have much health to begin with. Maybe that's That's one reason to why I... Oops, I forgot to pop the cat potion, because I'm an idiot. What's new? Let's see here. Dimeridian. Yeah, let's do the moon dust as well. I don't need to do it, but... wait. Did I just pop another swallow? What the hell? What just happened? I'm just gonna stand here for a while and regen my life. Very slowly. Oh my god. Geralt, you hunk. God damn. He's jacked. He's fucking pumped. Man, he's swollen. Whew, if only I could look. Even if I looked like a tenth as good as... I can see the floorboards. I guess that's the courtyard up there. If I even looked a tenth as good as Geralt does, man. Whew. Mercy. How's the health going? Come on. Oh my god. I guess this is punishment. Alright, that's enough. Let's go. I don't think that the moon dust actually does anything against wraiths, but... Eh. It doesn't look like Dimeridian does anything either, because they can still warp in and out, or phase in and out of existence and materialize behind me. Like I said, I have no idea if that actually helps, but I need every right. Okay, so I was caught on a ledge, and as I was falling down, they got me. Right, right. Jesus Christ, I hate fighting. Like, I mean, look at this. They're all attacking at the same time. Just one fucking line of code that instructs them to fight one on one. Okay, well, swallow it is. Not that swallow is gonna save me. And they have so much health. This is a... Oh, okay. I guess, fuck me. That was way too logical and way too clever of an idea. Of course, it wasn't gonna work. And then he dodges. Like, this is not fun anymore. I don't know what... Somebody over at CD Projekt Red should have been like, guys, this is kind of insane. All of the enemies just attack completely chaotically and just gang up on the player willy-nilly. And it just isn't a lot of fun. There's not a lot of tactics that the player can employ when he's fighting something like wraiths. Maybe we should... No. Maybe we should not do it. Maybe we should simply restrict the enemies a bit so that doesn't happen. No? Okay, I guess we can fuck off early to lunch then. And once again, I forgot cat potion. I'm not in a happy mood right now. I'm sorry, this is just bullshit. fighting rates is aggravating enough as it is. Having to fight three of them in this small space is insane. It's insane, and it's not fun, and it's this is not a challenge as much as it is just get lucky. I got one. I should be able to get them. Wow.
Not bad.
That was the second one. I don't know, maybe much ado about nothing, or maybe I'm just pissed, or maybe I'm right. I don't know. I think I'm right. I mean, anybody who's played this game can attest to the fact that, you know, shit gets chaotic sometimes. If you don't think so, bump up the difficulty. I know that I'm the one who, you know, chose to play on Death March New Game Plus. I know. But I still maintain that it's just, there's difficulty and then there's just, you know, bad design. I don't think that having 8 enemies being able to hit you at the same time is in any way fair or balanced or enjoyable. Imagine if they could do that in the Batman Arkham games. That's, it would be madness. To the right, Honorable Raphael von Burman, Lord of Zutzer Castle. We wish to reassure you, my dear sir, that your daughter is in the flower of good health. She will continue to enjoy said health, provided her father acts according to our instructions. They are as follows. In 6 days, at the exact stroke of midnight, you, sir, are to present yourself in person outside the cursed chapel near Brunwich in order to hand over a ransom in the amount of 1,000 unshaven Novigrad crowns. You are to sound no alarm, and come alone, with no guards or retainers of any sort. I trust we needn't add that any failure to follow these instructions will result in an immediate and proportionate decline in the young and beautiful Lady Borman's health. My best wishes to you, sir. Wow, even with cat potion, I can't see anything. This is it? This is it? Hold up. Where's the other part of the journal? Have I missed it? Where's the journal? I don't. This can't be it. That shitty treasure, that's all I have to look forward to here? I mean, I guess we should be able to infer from that ransom letter that the father did not, in fact, bail out his daughter. Because the Leshen has basically just reduced everything to fucking chaos here. Or, I don't know, maybe he did pay for the ransom, but just we get the last, we get the rest of the story in the Zeuser Castle, which I guess should be the one north of here? Is that it? Is that what's going on here? We need to go to the Zeuser Castle and, you know, read up on the, Count Romilly's Journal Part 2, Tarnished Key. Last page is torn from Count Romilly's journal. A pox upon Anastasia von Bormann, a pox upon her whole plowing house. I finally found a way to end this deadly little charade she's put on. The key to unraveling the riddle lay in a dusty old tome in my library. That little viperess was marked by a lesion. Yep, like I said before, that is why the monster attacked my castle. There was only one way out of the situation. I snuck up while she slept and throttled her. Ah, well, now we know what happened to her. She didn't even manage to peep. Now I can finally leave my castle walls, thank the gods. The monstrosity has skirted off into oblivion along with that accursed child. That entire affair was a horrific error. I'm just glad the savings from the previous missions are safely preserved in the castle treasury. I must recruit some mage, perhaps that will ensure I avoid such incidents in the future. Okay, so let's go back. Fuck me. I missed that the treasure down there because I just assumed that it was inside the castle. Fuck me. This episode has been an absolute nightmare. Okay, so where could this chest be? I guess it's here, yeah. A little better shit here. The Secret Life of Count Romilly. Well. Okay, so that's that again. Wow! Okay, so. I don't know what to say. I genuinely don't. We're out of time, so I can't head on over to the Zeuser Castle and check out what's going on there. And I don't know if I'm gonna spend another episode here in Velen, when in fact I was planning on going to Toussaint in the next episode. Well, I guess we'll see. We'll see what happens. I think we'll carry on. Jesus. Holy shit. We'll carry on as planned. I think we'll just head on over to Toussaint. Thanks for watching, everybody. I'm sorry about the negative vibes from this episode, but woo, yay. I'll see you in the next one. Va fail.